We're here at the office of Alex Martelli, the well-known Python programmer and author. Let's go in and talk to Alex.
In traditional Python, type is strongly connected to an object. An object's type is absolutely crucial to that object, but it's not connected to the name. A name, a variable, if you want to call it that, I would prefer to use the word name, can indicate any object whatsoever. There is no constraint. A name is a name is a name. Well, if it quacks like a duck and walks like a duck, it's a duck. Turns out, it was discovered a few years later, that there's actually a bird which, while it does, like, is morphologically indistinguishable from a duck, but its DNA analysis proved it's a goose. So, well, but the point is that if you were a chef and needed to decide how to cook it, you'd probably want to use duck recipes because it doesn't have the amount of fat of the goose, so you don't really care about the DNA. So instead of checking the type of an object, the concept was just make sure it has the methods with the signatures that you need, which you can do simply by trying, and that leads us to it being easier to ask forgiveness and permission. You try, literally, within a try statement, and if the signature is wrong or the name of the method is wrong, you get attribute error, type error, and catch it in an except clause and either propagate the error or handle it appropriately. Now, with the introduction of abstract base classes, the type becomes useful because it's not anymore a type in the sense of an implementation. It's a type in the sense of an abstraction. So, for example, there's a numbers abstract base class, and if you want to verify that your argument is a number, actually asking if it is an instance of number, it doesn't constrain at all the implementation. Obviously, internally, the implementation of unbounded precision integer versus, say, a 32-bit float is going to be drastically different, but they're both numbers, meaning they both have greater than, less than, plus, minus, times, and so on. So that kind of type check is now respectable in Python. Not anything concrete, but checked for the abstraction. It's a duck-typed constraint, if you will. If it is a number, then you're guaranteed of all a set of methods, operators, and signatures that you don't have to check separately. So look at it as a bundle of such operations.